Say Islands, many women are the breadwinners of their families. This is so because men tend to abandon their families because of their migratory nature in search for fish from island to island.
Nalongo Lilian Chitone has spent 10 years in this business. She narrates that it's not only an income generating job, but a father to their children, women themselves, because men are no longer fathers nor husbands. This river fish is our backbone because we are times abandoned by our men, whom we call our husbands, and the only way to survive is engaging into this river fish drying business so that we can pay school fees for our children and looking after our families. From it, she has managed to construct her own house at Kasekulo landing site, among many other benefits. Among the challenges are heavy rains, which doesn't allow silver fish to dry well, and instead rot from the drying yards. Sometimes it rains and traders become scarce. Our stores get full of it, which leads to rotting also, and many have vacated the job to villages mainly due to losses resulting from heavy rain. A kilogram of dry silver fish costs shillings 5,000, and Liliani is a trader who sells it at shillings 6,500. She has managed to take care of her two children, pay school fees, as well as buying food for them. Nalongo's appeal to government is availing markets for their silver fish. We appeal to the government for availing ready and steady markets where we can sell these silver fish, either in the country or even in the neighboring countries. Timothy Chimera, one of the Kasekulo landing site leaders, says that women have not only lifted the burden of irresponsible men, but also promoted development in their community.
Actually, women have fought very hard to do things that earn them cash. Because, men are abandoning them. They don't pay school fees. They don't pay for rent. At times, they even don't leave money behind for them to get food. So they end up doing that work.
It's a full-time job for women, since they also have to chase away birds that consume it to avoid losses. Women spend the day in the drying yards guarding their products. Though they struggle hard, taxes levied on it are high, as well as considering it as an illegal fishing method, forcing many to leave it, as Selina Nabutono, who once held the fishing boats, narrates. The bad thing about our president assigning his greedy people to implement programs such as Emyoga and PDM, which we could use to boost our business, and whenever he comes to islands, we don't get a chance of speaking and explaining to him, because they are always prepared people with prepared speeches. Besides river fish drying, aged women also engage in collecting snail shells, which are jointly mixed in chicken and pig feeds, at least for a kilogram of sugar.
River fish business employs approximately 80% of the women in Kalangala underlying islands. I am Samuel Nkuba, reporting for the news in Sese Islands.